They decide to waltz. We certainly have examples that there's no love lost between these two clubs. Remind the fact that one team's already got first place locked up. There's lots of emotion here, you can be sure of that.
That's Vecchia and Headington, 3-11. Rick Sabuki is the linesman in between the two of them.
These guys don't want to really waltz either, do they? It's not what you call a love in today.
Now, where number 32 has a hold of Tim Hoover. Hoover's 5'11". Ware is 6'4". Looks like they said, we've had enough words. Now it's time for some action.
Now, this is right on the verge of breaking out now. This is not a waltz, I'll tell you that.
Rob Vecchia and Steve Headington, the combatants.
They've thrown them right there, only it's Rob Vecchia's got quite a few of them in there, and Headington's just hanging on now, and everybody else is paired up. There's going to be,
all right, now Kroger,
the 260, Kroger
and the Premier. Delgarno and Kroger, the 216s.
This is,
it's Delgarno and Kroger.
This thing is right on
Look
the verge.
Boy,
they're throwing them, too, I'll tell you something.
They are big and strong.
That Delgarno is 3 years younger, too, and that's quite a minute, you know. He's standing right in there.
Well, Delgarno is 6'3". Robert is 6'3". It's all over the ice. Everybody has squared off. And now a return battle. Vecchia and Headington, a return battle. Now Bonner has hold of Joy. They're down. Now the goalkeeper, Chris Cousy, has left his net. Scott Mosey, the goalkeeper, has left his. And off the bench,
Chris Brandt.
Chris Brandt has come off the bench. There it is.
We got something going now.
What a scene this is. The goalkeepers have gone at it.
This is just, look at these goalies really go after it.
A goalkeeper. All right, who?
My God, they can't possibly keep control of this thing. This thing.
Britt Peer and Shane Corson are on your screen now. It started after the whistle. It started with words. It started with shoving and pushing. All right, here's another battle that's gone on here. Vecchia, who initiated it all, but now mixed up with Lyle Jonathan. Maybe we can get a shot of this. Lyle Jonathan is Stan Jonathan's cousin. He's was called up from the Brantford Junior B team. There are about six main events going on at the present time. An impossible situation for the officials to handle.
Absolutely impossible.
I would say it is up to the coaches now to intervene. There's another, well, when I say another, I could refer to about nine different altercations going on. There is Bill LaForge, the Hamilton coach.
Going to take the coaches now to do something about it, to step in, and the goalies
are
into it.
Goalkeepers, there's Terry Kirst. That's Peter Richards, the Hamilton backup netminder. side, the blue line down here at the opposite end, Lyle Jonathan of the Hamilton Steelhawks and Rob Vecchia of the Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds. So this is the one that looks like is about to ignite. All right, we'll be back in a moment. We are back. The situation is unchanged. They're still going at it. There's Terry Crisp. We've seen him.
You can be sure that he's discussed with
there's Bill LaForge.
They both are. I think they both want this.
Most of the action now, I shouldn't say that. It was Peter Richards, the backup goalkeeper, came right across the ice. I'm not sure who that is for the Greyhounds.
That's Mosey, isn't it?
I absolutely have no idea. No idea.
It'll take as much time to clean this whole ice surface up and get it settled down. And they get the penalties just to get this whole thing.
It is Mosey. Referee John Wilsey, nothing they can do.
No, absolutely not.
That's Peter Richards, number 30, the backup netminder for Hamilton, and Scott Mosey, the starting goalkeeper for Sault Ste. Marie.
There's no description. There's absolutely no description.
It has been a long time since I have seen anything like this.
A long time. The funny thing about it, it'd be something like this that makes a lot of news, but it's a very seldom occurrence.
This is the exception rather than the norm, no matter what anybody might write or say.
It really is.
There have been ill feelings between the two teams all season long.
It's they made a big trade early in the year, and both those guys.
That's Guy Girard, number four, right down here in the blue line, number four. Guy Girard went after Wayne Gruel. Now Lyle Jonathan, the rookie, number 20, has moved in for Hamilton. This has gone on and on and on. And I regret to say there is no sign of it ending right at the present time. I don't know what it will take.
That's the tragedy of this thing. It seems like it just... We just get it settled in, and then a couple of other people go at it, and